Hello, everyone, and thank you for having me here. Thanks for the award. So I wanted to tell you what happened when a few days ago when I woke up. I wasn't dressed like that. I woke up in my bed, so I didn't have a hat on. And there was this letter. I just brought it here, just above my bed. I was sleeping normally, just in my pyjama, and I have a little trap. I live in a little trailer in the Croatian desert at the moment, and there's a little trap so I can see the stars, and it's beautiful at night. And I woke up in that morning, and there was this letter on my bed, and I was, God, what is this letter doing there? And I opened it, and I was like, it's a letter. It's a fellowship letter. I was like, wow, this is an invitation to be a fellowship. So, this has fallen from the sky. That letter has fallen from the sky. This is a sign of God. Letter falling from the sky. Then I told my grandma, I was like, oh, look, I've got this letter on my bed. And she said, well, yeah, it's a fellowship. She said, fellowship? Wow, they might even play trumpets for you. Or the queen might be here. Or, you know, or you might even be dressed like you lived in the Middle Ages still. So I told my granddad, he just came back, he was lost in a tunnel and doesn't want to talk about it, but he came back and he's next door, and I say, granddad, look, I've got these letters fallen from the sky, and it's to give me a fellowship. He's like, ugh. He was so pissed off, he's like, ugh, anyway, all your work is about me, and why didn't they not give me the fellowship? So I went to the priest and asked him, they say, oh no, it's just a letter fell from the sky. Like, I know it's a sign of God. It's time for me to reflect on my time at St. Martin's. And going to art school 20 years ago when I was about 52 years old. So yeah, how a different place it was then. I didn't have to pay any fee. I was really welcome as a European. Still welcome, of course. I feel totally part of it, and I feel we'll be together forever. I felt I could... it was an amazing time for me, actually. I could really grow freely as possible. My position as a woman was never even passing through my mind. I was just doing my work as an artist, and things, of course, you start to position yourself as you go, but it was really this moment of total freedom and questioning ideas and... all the people I met, the great mentor and teacher, I had John Smith, who was very influential on me, Fiona Banner, Anton Antaya, Graham Elad, a lot of them who stayed friends, which was totally amazing. Of course, all the friends from students, friends which stay forever. It was pretty unstructured as well, a quite messy place, but it was brilliant. It's all discussed a lot of art. I experienced so much art. I mean, seeing the best art was everything I could learn, and discussing things together. It was amazing. And then I also, after St. Martin's, I started assisted John Latham, who taught at St. Martin's a few years before. And he is, for me, my kind of conceptual, another grandfather. I think we all have a lot of grandfathers in history in some ways, or part of us. And he was definitely a very important part of my work. So yeah, this day can't really be about what's wrong, what's good, what's God or evil or in or art, but we're growing in a discussion, growing our knowledge and discovering our own language. I think it's really the place where you discover your own voice, free to express ideas, learn to articulate feeling and ideas, and to do this together, cross-nationality, social background, art, and art education especially hold a unique place where we can foster expression, ideas, and the ability to see things from different point of view. It needs to be cherished and protected in such uncertain time. And St. Martin did give me this without me even realizing. It's a sign of dog!